Hello friends, welcome to Quest for Knowledge. Today I have brought the question plus answers of the model paper 2 of history. So let's get started with the part A. So what is the meaning of the word historia? It's inquiry. What is ziggurat? It's the temple of tall tower. Who was the proponent of Taoism? It's Lao Tse. Which is the most ancient civilization of Europe? It's Greek. What do you mean by Christ? It's anointed one. Who explored the mainland of South America? It's Amerigo Vespucci. Which country was called as the motherland of Italy? Okay, Renaissance. Okay, motherland of Renaissance. It's Italy. What is meant by revolution? A complete change. Expand USSR, Union, Soviet, Society, Republic. So the 10th question is, who is the present Secretary General of UNO? It's Antonio Guterres. Write any two professional uses of history. History is the main core subject for the completion of examination like IAS, KAS, IPS, etc. The historical knowledge is a mother of necessity for student, teacher, lawyer, etc. Mention two animals are considered as the nearest relative of man. It's chimpanzee and baboons.
It's bonobo.
Bonobos. It's baboons.
Bonobo is the answer.
Which are the river valleys called the cradle of civilization? So most of the civilization in the world develop on the bank of the rivers. The places where men settled first were naturally those part of the world where the soil was rich and water available for drinking and irrigation. White and flat lands through which great rivers ran and had a warm climate. Man appeared about 5.6 million years ago, but started civilization life only 7,000 years ago. Civilized men made the most remarkable progress in the shortest possible time. So the next question is, name any two historians of ancient Rome. It's Sallust and Plutarch. Which are the two sects of Islam? It's Shia and Sunnis. Who was the John Wycliffe and to which country did he belong? He was early leader of Reformation and he belonged to England. Who drafted the Declaration of American Independence is Thomas Jefferson, Samuel Adams. Mention any two work of Karl Marx, is Das Kapital and Communist Manifesto. Name the two power blocks formed during the First World War. It's Bolsheviks and Mensheviks. What was the League of Nations established? Where was it headquartered? The League of Nations came into the existence in 1920. Its headquarter is in Geneva in Switzerland. Let's move to part C. Explain the importance of the study of history. The study of history gives us an account of the education, evolution of the culture of mankind, of science and ancient times. History present an ocean of experience of different people, hence the study of history has been useful to man in many ways. The study of history gives us information about the biographies of great men and a record of major events of the world. It provides us an insight into process of struggle of mankind, his interaction with environment, his rise and fall. Hence, it is essential for men to understand his surrounding in the entire world, which will add to his awareness and intellect. History is a medieval Europe was the monopoly of the church and men for and monopoly of the church for several churchmen for several centuries. Okay. After that, write about the socio-economic condition of the Mesopotamia. So the Mesopotamia society was divided into four: the royal, priest, rich landlord, and merchant and slave. So priest and scribes held high post in the administration, but the farmer, artist, craftsman, shopkeeper, merchant formed the third stage, followed by slaves. Okay. So, agriculture was their main occupation. They reared the buffaloes, goats, donkey. They used the water wisely by digging canals from both the rivers. So, after that, we have write a note on Confucius and his philosophy. So, Confucius was the greatest of the Chinese philosopher. He lost his father at the age of 3 and he faced lots of difficulties. Confucius learned archery and music. And the philosophy of Confucius is known as Confucianism. The principle of Confucius has basis in common with Chinese tradition and beliefs. So now let's write a short note on Julius Caesar. So Julius Caesar was a great general, dictator, reformer and symbol of ancient Rome. By this line, this emerged the first triumvirate, Pompey, Julius Caesar and Crassus. Pompey was a trained soldier and a counselor. Crassus was a wealthy nobleman and Julius Caesar was the commander. And the three divided the empire among themselves. So Caesar got Gaul, Crassus got Partha, that is Iran, and Pompey in Spain. After being in victory in several battles in Gaul and Britain, Caesar sent frequent report to Rome. He sent his famous message to the Senate. Vini, vidi, visi. I came, I saw, I conquered. He brought about many changes in Roman. He also brought many reforms. After this, we have explained the teachings of Jesus Christ. So, Jesus preached the existence of one God. Jesus preached fatherhood of God and brotherhood of men. Jesus believed in forgiveness. He emphasized upon love towards mankind. According to Jesus, humility, purity of heart, sincerity, humanity, okay? Purity, sincerity and fulfillment of duty were the gateway to heaven. To become perfect, one should give up worldly richness. Jesus said, service to people is service to God. Jesus gave the message of love and compassion. Mention the result of French Revolution. There were many great philosophers during 18th of century in France. They criticized the political tyranny of economic exploitation, social inequality in France. Popular among the philosophers, Montesquieu, Voltaire, Jean Jacques Rousseau, Montesquieu wrote The Spirit of Law. He supported parliamentary of democracy. Voltaire was famous satirist. He wrote letters on the English in which he asked people to apply reason in every field. He strongly criticized the church social inequality. These all the philosophical ideas were the great inspiration for the French Revolution. Now let's move on to the map. So as you can see, where you need to mark Berlin, Rome, Cape of Good Hope in South Africa tip, Mecca, there only in South Africa, in the center point. And we have Babylon, even the same after Rome, we have Babylon. These are the thing you have to mark over. I hope it is clear to you. So first is Babylon. So here you can see it is written, there is a Hammurabi who ruled and Nebuchadnezzar who built the Hanging Garden in Babylon. After that, about Rome, it is the capital of Italy. It was also the capital of Roman Empire. Vatican City is in Rome. It is in the center of the Pope, who is the religious head of the Catholics. After that, we have Mecca. It is in Saudi Arabia. Prophet Muhammad, the founder of Islam, was born here. It is regarded as the hottest city, hostest city of Islam. Okay, after that we have Cape of Good Hope. It is in South Africa. Bartholomew Das called it as a Cape of Storm. Vasco da Gama renamed it as Cape of Good Hope. After that we have Berlin, present capital city of Germany. It is located in the bank of River Spree. After World War II, it was divided as East and West Berlin by dividing wall was built. Okay. In 1990, both East and West Germany were again reunited and the Berlin Wall was removed. Now, let's move on and understand the part E. Describe the contribution of Egyptian civilization. So, probably the first civilization that developed was in Egypt on the bank of River Nile. Egypt is in northern part of African continent. Egypt is the gift of Nile. Because of the plenty of food, fodder and uninterrupted supply of water was possible. It is the sources of Egyptian civilization. As you see, the important sources of Egyptian civilizations are pyramid, the temple, the innumerable image like Sphinx, host of painting, etc. Political condition: the early people settled into villages, which developed into cities, and later the city states were formed. They were ruled by kings and known as pre-dynastic period. What was the status of the women? It was, they enjoyed exceptionally high status, such as high status was not enjoyed by the women of any other civilization. So any first empress we got, it's from Egypt itself. After that, we have craft and manufacture. Egyptian developed a variety of craft and manufacturing: stone cutter, mason, carpenter, jewelry, pottery, etc. Trade and commerce, as you can see, Egyptian developed both internal and external trade. And religion, they had a significant role in the life of the people. Polytheism, worshipping of many gods, was there in practice. So here we have literature and learning. Egyptian developed pictograph writing. It is one of the earliest form of writing. Art and architecture, Egyptians were great builders. They developed fine arts. Their art and architecture reflected their culture. They built temples for their gods and pyramids to bury their kings. After that, sir, the second question we have is, describe the political and non-political achievement of UNO. So political, we have in the political field, the UNO has notable achievement. The foremost achievement of UNO is that there has been not been global war and use of nuclear weapons since 1945. In 1947, the quarrel started in the Indonesia between Holland and Indonesia. It was settled by the UN in 1948. In September 1948, France, England, USA complained to the Security Council about the blockade of Berlin by the USSR. Later, an agreement was reached due to the effort of UNO. It was able to stop the fighting between the Israeli Jews and Arabs in Palestine in 1948. The UNO ordered ceasefire in Kashmir in 1948. In the Korean crisis, where it was broke out between North and South Korea, the UNO issued armed forces to settle the dispute. And now let's move on and understand the non-political achievements. So there have been more non-political achievements, like there have been adoption of Universal Declaration of Human Rights in the General Assembly on 10th December 1948. The declaration included articles like the right to life, liberty, security of person, freedom from slavery, freedom of thought, the right to vote, the right to work, etc. And UNO has done excellent work through specialized agencies. International Labour Organization also has made member nation to improve the condition of the laborers. So even IMF, IBRD are giving funds to the economic development of different backward countries. UNESCO also has done a good work in making backward countries in the social, educational, economic, technical and other field. And it has preserved many cultural sites throughout the world, like Hampi, Padadakal, Konark, etc. in India. After that, we have matchup. Shahu Wangti, it's Great Wall of China. Prophet Muhammad, founder of Islam. Prince Henry, the navigator. Martin Luther, he's the manifestation of reformation. Lenin, new economic policy. Now we'll move on and understand the chronological order. First it comes origin of earth. After that it comes the city of Rome. Okay, the city of Rome. After that it comes, After that it comes the capture of Constantinople by Turk. After that it comes industrial revolution. And then it comes Paris Peace Conference. So don't make mistake in this, okay? So please try to cover, write this one proper. So first will be A correct. A, B is correct. After that we'll have capture of Constantinople by Turk. After that only industrial revolution and Paris Peace Conference will come in the last. So that is all about. I hope this video helps. If you like this video, do like, share and subscribe. Thank you very much.